Hello students, so we are looking on to the contribution of the Western and the Indian sociologist. So now second, earlier we had seen August Comte. Now moving on to Herbert Spencer, 1820 to 1903. Herbert Spencer was an English philosopher born in the Derby, England, 27th April 1820. He was one of the pioneers of the sociology and been described the Spencer's sociology and sociological Darwinistic. Okay, as he is described as a sociological Darwinist. Spencer has been called the second father of sociology. So your first father of sociology is August Comte, and your second father is your Herbert Spencer. Being famous evolutionist, Spencer was very much influenced by Charles Darwin's the book Origin of Species. Okay, so Herbert Spencer was he got influenced by the Origin of Species books by your Darwin. He tried to apply theory of biological evolution to sociology. Okay, so he also tried to apply the biological evolution to sociology. Spencer used the concept of evolution of animals to explain the evolution of society. He compared the society of human organism. His theory of organic analogy was very much become popular earlier, even though it has been rejected now. Spencer claimed that man mind has evolved in the same way from the simple atomic responses of lower animals to the process of reason and thinking of man. Okay, so Herbert Spencer was influenced by your Darwin's. Darwin's theory is that we are from modern ape to modern man, we have been developed. Okay, so the same way Herbert Spencer said that we have the mind of a animal, lower animal, which has been developed. Okay, but this theory was been rejected. Spencer believed in two kinds of knowledge: knowledge gained by the individual and knowledge gained by the race. Okay, so from an individual and through your race, through your color. Okay, he also developed a theory of two types of society. They are militant society, industrial society. Okay, militant, the working class, industrial society. These are corresponding to evolutional progression. Thus, according to him, society is changing from simple form to complex form. So, Herbert Spencer said that society is now simple, but it is trying to become a very, very complex society. Okay, Herbert Spencer stressed that the old society should be considered as a unit of study. So, he said that old society, we should study the whole society to understand the complete society. According to him, different parts of society are interrelated and interdependent. Okay, so the society is interrelated and interdependent. Not only the parts influence the whole system, but also the whole system influence the parts. Okay, so not only the parts influence the whole system, but the whole system is influenced by different parts. While explaining the stages of the development of society, his attitude of comparison draws a special attention. Okay, so he explains the stages of society, but when he is explaining it, his attitude derives the most of comparisons. Okay, as a social thinker, Spencer has done what Comte plans to do. Okay, so what Comte had the plan towards to develop sociology as subject and society, the same thought Herbert Spencer also had. Okay, major works of Herbert Spencer are Social Static, The First Principles, Principles of Ethics, The Man, Virus State, The Study of Sociology, Principles of Sociology. Okay, so The Study of Sociology and Principles of Sociology is considered the most famous work of Herbert Spencer. Moving on to the next sociologist, Alain de Rackheim. Alain de Rackheim was definitely one of the most important contributors in sociological knowledge. De Rackheim, the French philosopher, also considered society as an important unit of sociology study. So everyone who studies sociology, they saw society as a basic unit where they can go and study. Okay, like Spencer, his comparative method leads an important study different types of society comparatively. Okay, so you had a method called comparative method where you can go study the society based on comparing each society. Okay, if one society is different and comparing othering, and then you try to match it. De Rackheim believed that we must study social life with the same objective as scientists study. Okay, so how scientists study the natural world, the same way we also as sociologists we should study how society is being there. He was the first sociologist who emphasized the reality of society. Okay, so he was the first one who emphasized the nature of reality of society. He introduced rules of sociological method. Okay, so the rules of sociological method was being introduced by De Rackheim. He carried out the scientific study of society. So he was the one who carried out the scientific method of studying society, where you will go sit, you will go study a society completely. De Rackheim's opinion is that man's social behavior has to understand not by personal view but by social background. Okay, so man's view should understand through social background. He says that human event called social So any human event, it is called as social. According to him, we perform every action in interest of society. Our duties practice are defined through law. Okay, our duties is been practiced through law and custom. We have not created the duties, but have inherited it. Okay, so each one will not create the duties. Okay, duties is something we inherit from our parents. Okay, it is not something which is you create something new the next day you have been born. Okay, something which has been followed, we also try to follow the same duties. Through our education, formal and informal, we get the duties. Then the types of conduct are called as social facts. Okay, these types of conducts which we get inherited is called as social facts. In the words of Durkheim, a social fact is every way of action, fixed or not, capable of exercising on the individual and external constraint. Okay, so a social fact is in every way is acting, fixed or not. Okay, capable of exercising, we try to exercise it. Okay, individual, external, consistent. Durkheim used the theory of anomia in his book on the Davison of lab or in society. Okay, so what is anomia? Okay, we'll see. Durkheim used the theory of anomia in his book on Davison of lab or in society. Him to suicide, a social fact that takes place due to the external force. Okay, so when an individual is having a thought of suicide, it comes from the outside thought, it is not from within him. The outside pressure which he is having, because of that reason he tries to suicide. The outline four types of suicide he gave, they are egoistic suicide, anomia suicide, altruistic suicide, fatalistic suicide. Okay, Durkheim was impressed by the fact of that religion is a universal in human society. So religion is something very universal in human society, and he felt that religion plays a vital role in maintaining the society. So religion plays a vital role in maintaining the society as the old religious belief emerges from the society. So we have the old religious belief which comes from the society and helps to hold the society together. Durkheim laid foundation for various specialized field. Okay, so Durkheim has laid foundation for various specialized field for study of general sociology, sociology as religion, sociology as moral. Inside sociology, you give different streams where people can study on sociology. Sociology of law, sociology of crime, economic sociology, and he also introduced a lot of other things. Major works of Durkheim are the division of labor in society, the rules of sociologist method, the elementary forms of religious life. He started a journal by name Annie, Sociology Q, to popularize sociological writing. Okay, so people who used to write on sociology, they could come and publish in this famous journal called Annie. Okay, next, moving on to Karl Marx, 1818 to 1883. So you know, Karl Marx is an economist, he's also a sociologist from Germany. Karl Marx was one of the most important thinker of 19th century. Karl Marx was born in 5th May in Terrar of Germany. He was the son of prosperous Ribler lawyer. Karl Marx completed his doctoral thesis in philosophy from the University of Jena. His writings very much affected the government of France, and he was exiled to England and lived there till his death. Through Marx had studied philosophy, he was not philosopher. He was a social thinker who advocated the end of oppression and exploitation. Okay, so what happened? He finished his studies and he was a philosopher by thought. Okay, but what happened? His doctor, after finishing it, his writings were affected by the government of France. Because of that, he was to go into exile. He came to England and started living in England. But more than a philosopher, he was more than a social thinker. He was a good social thinker who said that you have to stop oppression and exploitation in the society towards the poor people. Karl Marx is considered to be one of the founders of modern sociology. So the founder of modern sociology is Karl Marx, because of his theory, the social change, and his analysis of social conflict and revolution. Okay, so why is the founders of modern sociology is because of theory, social change, and he analyzed the social conflicts in the revolution. Marx has argued the human society had progressed through different stages. Capitalism was the latest phase of human advancement, but Marx believed that it would give way for socialism. In order to understand the work of the capitalism, Marx undertook elaborate study of political, social, and especially in economic aspects. Okay, so what happened? Okay, Marx didn't study sociological aspects based on only sociological subject, because slowly the society has been becoming into progress, and also it's becoming capitalistic. Okay, so because of, when you have to understand this, you have to study politically, socially, and also economically. So all the three aspects was being studied by Karl Marx to give a good base for the society. Karl Marx never called himself a sociologist, but his works is very rich in sociological aspects. Marx believed that the task of social scientists was to change it. Marx believed that the capitalistic society would be transformed by the victims. Okay, so the capitalist society is where, what say, you have to work, you have to be working, the rich will be becoming richer and the poor will be become poorer. Okay, the victims, that are the working class are the victims. Okay, Marx convinced of the inevitability of social revolution. According to him, class conflict, okay, what is class conflict? The higher class, upper class, middle class, always there is a differences which is being there. In The Key to History, he says that the history of the ether of existing society, nothing but classes conflict between capitalistic and the labor. Okay, so always you have conflicts between the upper class and the working class, who suffer a lot in the society. Okay, the upper class always putting down the lower class. He also believed that the historic struggle would end only with establishment of the free, harmonious and classless society. Okay, so if you have classless society, in the classless society, then you can develop good base. Marx placed very great emphasis on the economic structure and the process because he believed that they form the foundation of every social system. Throughout human history, Marx argued that people, idea and beliefs originated from the economic system of which they were part. According to him, material life shaped ideas. Ideas did not shape material life. If we understand how the economy works and how it has been changing in the past, he argued, we can learn how to change society in future. How can such change be brought about? Marx's answer is, though, class struggle. Okay, so what happened? You can bring changes in the society. Okay, works and how the changing can happen, but what happens? Class struggle will be there. Okay, because always the working class will be working throughout their life. Okay, the upper class will always be becoming developed. So always there is struggle. Modern sociology rejected many ideas of Marx. Okay, so modern sociologists, they didn't take Marxist ideologies, but they generally recognize the fundamental influence of economic. Okay, because as an economist, he was very famous. Areas of society is conflict approach is very much helpful to understand the social phenomena. Okay, so his conflict, you can understand the social phenomena to his conflict approach. His major works are The German Ideology, The Poverty of the Philosophy, The Holy Family, the Manifesto of Communist Party, Das Kapital. This can also be called as the Communist Manifesto, and the Das Kapital are the famous works of Karl Marx. Next, moving on to Max Weber. After Emmeline Durkheim, Max Weber is another German sociologist to influence sociology. Okay, see, Karl Marx, we saw him as a economist, sociologist and also as a philosopher, but not completely as a sociologist. He didn't consider himself as a sociologist. According to him, sociology is a science that attempts to interpretive understanding of social action. Okay, so you try to understand the social action to arrive at causal explanation of its course and effects. Weber attempted to explain the basis characteristics of bureaucracy. Okay, so Weber always tried to set us talk to us about the characteristics of bureaucracy. He implicated presented rationalization as a master trends Western capitalist and contributed to the comparative religion to establish the economic phenomena. So he wanted to establish the economic phenomena in the society. Governed by the religious ethos, he constructed the typology of social action. So sociology of typology of social action was being introduced. Traditional, affectional, vocational, instrumental action, value rationally. Weber analyzed authority on rationality. Okay, legal, traditional, chargamatic, the economic of society, the protest ethics and spirit of capitalism, city bureaucracy. The principles of sociology and economic origin are important works of Weber. Okay, so there are two important works, the principles of social and economic organization are the important works of Max Weber. So other Western philosophers are W.G. Summer, H.M. Johnson, Max Weber, Cole, Ginsberg, Ogben, Ross, Habhaus, Raymond, Laplace, Lévi-Strauss, George Simmel, Carl Mahim, Talcott Parsons, Merton, Kingsley Davis, Merton and others. So these are the other philosophers who are there. So we saw the important philosophers like Auguste Comte, Emily Durkheim, Karl Marx and Max Weber. So in the next class, we'll be dealing with the Indian sociologists. Thank you, children.